Hello students, welcome to AutoCAD tutorial number 5. In this video we are going to learn few more modification commands. So here I have given the table, the different tools that we are going to learn, the match property, mirror, array, extend, hatch, pedit, like this. So there may be other tools also, but these are very important. So we are going to learn them. So here I have given the description as well as commands. So let's look at the first type, match property. Now this is used to match the property of one element to the other. Now to make use of this tool, the command is match prop. So you can type the whole command in the command toolbar, or you can just start typing this MAT, then the whole thing appears. So let's see how this works. So we'll go to our AutoCAD and we'll try to use this one, match properties. So let's go to AutoCAD software. Okay, so let's create some geometries. Say for example, I want to create a line here. Okay, maybe of some dimensions, and say I have some other say elements like line here, the circle here, or maybe a rectangle here. So these are some random elements that I have created. So I just want to demonstrate how this match property tool works. So this tool I had just given some explanation in previous tutorials. So but let's see again. Okay, now property means, for example, if you want to check the property of a particular element, you need to select that element, and in the command line you need to type MO. So this will open up a window. So it is getting open, and that window is called as the property window. As you can see, it is coming here. So at the beginning it will take a bit of time. So okay, now I have already selected that line. You can see this window, that means this is the property window of that line. So you can deselect that line. So now these properties are assigned to nothing. So just select and see its properties. For example, if you want to change this line type, as we have discussed in previous tutorials. So for example, you want to change this line to say some other type of line. Maybe, okay, these things are not loaded here, so we need to load them. So let's go to the line type command, which we have already learned. Let me close this one. So in the command line I am typing line type, enter. This window will appear, click on load. So these things we have already done in previous discussions. So select some of the lines. So let me select the center line, click OK here. Okay, now again select one of the object, go to property window. So type MO, press enter. Now this is the property window. The line is already selected. Now here go to line type, and you can see the center line is coming here. So click on there. So you can see now, just close this window, the center line is already assigned to it, but it is not visible. So if I can zoom in, then it is visible, but for this much of window size it should be visible. Okay, let's do some scaling there. Again select MO, enter. Again we get this window. Now here, now this line type we need to change. So let's take it as 5, enter. Now it's visible. Or let's change a bit more, 8. Okay, close this. still it's not properly visible. Again go to MO, enter. It's a trial and error. Let's use 16. Okay, now it's a bit visible. So okay, this is a center line that we have created. Now match property, what does it do? It's a tool that we can use just to assign property of one element to the other. For example, now this is a center line, so I want few more center lines to be drawn. So instead of drawing a line and going into properties and assigning that property to this line, so instead of doing that, so what we can do, we can simply assign property of this to this line by using match property tool. So here you have the icon for match property. You can simply click here and you can use it. So instead of that, what again we can do is just type the command, which is match property. So you can type MAT, then it will automatically come here, or you can type the whole thing, select it and read what computer is saying. Select source object. So this is my source object. Just click there and select destination object. Click. So you can observe the changes that are happening in this element. Now this element got the property of this element. You can again assign the property to this element also if you want, or yes, you can see, you can assign the property to this element also or to this element also. So this is how in nice way we can use this match properties. That means if you have some center line or maybe a dotted line or maybe some colored line like one I demonstrate here, we can simply use this tool to assign this. Now for example, now this is a continuous line, so I don't want center line now. So what can be done? Simply go here, click on this icon, that means match property, select the source object, then select the destination object. Now you can see the changes, right? So this is how we can make use of this match property. Now this will be very helpful to save our time. So instead of rather going to the property window, changing here every time, so it will be time consuming. So what we need to do is, so before we start any drawing, so we need to have these elements, ready-made elements like center line, the hidden lines. So as we start creating our drawings, we can make use of this just to transfer properties to the required elements. So this is about the match properties. So I hope you have understood this concept. Let's delete all these elements. Now go to our Word file and let's see the next type, mirror. So this is a bit interesting. Now this is used to create a mirror image of an element. So let's see the command. It's mirror. So you start typing MIR, the other things will automatically come. So let's see how this can be used. So go to our AutoCAD software. Say for example, I have a line here like this, and I have a circle here, or maybe some other geometry. Now I want this circle here, that means I want a mirror image of this circle with reference to this line. So now this is only one circle here, there may be some other elements which are symmetric about a particular line. So if they are symmetric, so just by drawing those elements on one side, we can just use this mirror command so that the other side will automatically get created. So I'm just in a simple way drawing, I have drawn this circle and I'm going to use the mirror command just for you can say demonstration. Okay, so let's type here mirror. Now it is coming, you can see here mirror. So mirror 3D, so don't worry about this mirror. So press enter. Now read the command, select objects. Which object? It is this. So this object I want to create a mirror image, so select that object, press enter, So please follow the steps that I am doing. So you can see here in the third file I have put a table. I have not given the steps how to do these things, so you need to listen to me for that. Okay, so go to software. Yeah, again I just want to repeat it. So mirror, press enter, select the object, again press enter, now again read, specify first point of mirror line. Now this is my mirror line, this is my reference line. So this is my first point and next point. So we have created a mirror image, but still we are in the mirror command. So read what computer is asking. Erase source object. So yes or no. So if you don't want to keep the source object, simply say yes. Or if you want to retain that part, say no. By default it is no, just press enter. So you have done. So we have created the same circle with reference to this line on this side. So there may be some other elements which we want to create the mirror image. So just use this mirror command for that particular work. So I hope you have understood this concept as well. So I'm going a little bit faster now. So just I will delete and we will go to the next type. Now what is the next type? You can see array. Now what is this? Now this is used to create array of elements. Now what is the command? Array. So how does this work? So this I will explain with some geometries. Say for example I have a circle here. C enter and a circle like this. And I have one more circle on the circumference, quadrant point here. Yes. Now the thing is that I want this circle to be placed on the circumference of the circle of this circle, that is the first circle, at equal you can say the spacing. I can keep any number of circles on the circumference at some proper, you can say, maintaining the distance between them. So in order to just do it, we can use the array command. So type array in the command line and you can select, you can see these options, or you can type array here. You can see these options: array polar, rectangle, path, edit and other things. There may be few more in the below. So for this particular drawing or geometry, you need to select this polar option. That means array polar. You can see the default image of it. So it will look like something like this. Okay, select array polar. Select the object. So this is my object. Click enter. Now specify center point of the array. Now the center point of the array will be the center of this circle. So this is the center of my array. So just click there. We have created array of this circle. Now it may be a requirement that we want some specific number of circles to be placed on this circle. Now here there are 6. So by default it gives us 6. So if you want some, say, 4 number of circles or maybe 3, just give that number in the command line. Now to give that number, you can just click on this part, that is items. Just click on this items, then it will ask us to specify number of items. So give 3. Yeah, something went wrong. So where is it? Yeah, sorry, it's here. So that was the rotate item. So it's here, items. So just click here. Now it is, by default it was 6. I want say 3. Yes. Oh, so we got only 3 circles placed on the circumference at equidistance. So this is how we can make use of array polar command. So I will demonstrate one more array type, that is the rectangular array type. So just right click, enter. So again I want to demonstrate a rectangle array. So directly I will go to the array, or okay, let me create one circle. C, enter, circle. Now this is the our object. Now we want to create array of this in a rectangle pattern. So just type array command, enter, select the, okay, one thing I didn't tell you. Now here, once you type the array command, you select this option directly, array RECT. This is for rectangle. So just click there and select the objects, press enter. So we have done it. So we have created the array, but you can see how many rows are there. There are two rows and four columns. Now we can customize them. That means we can have a control on the number of rows as well as the number of columns, and also the spacing between these two, you can say the circles. So that can be done with the options available here. For example, if you want to say change the number of columns from 4 by default, from 4 to say 3, so type 3, enter. So you can see the changes that are happening. So we got 4, I mean 3 columns. So if you want to change the number of rows, again press enter, you will get this menu. Click on rows, then say I want 3 rows. Yes, so something went wrong. Yeah, it came. So I had to zoom out it, so this part was hidden like this. So that was thing happening. Okay, so already we had three rows. So if you want to just see it again, so 3 was there, you can make it 4 like this. So this is how we can create array and make use of those we can say the circles. For example, it may be a requirement, like you have a rectangle here like this, and you have a circle somewhere here, and you want to create these circles at this point, say here and here. That means you want three columns and two rows of this circle to be placed within this rectangle. Then you can use this array command. So instead of going circle by circle or maybe copy command, you can make use of this array. So this is on about the array command. So let's go to our Word file and see what is the next command. So just erase this one, go to the next command, I mean the tool, and that is extend. Now this is used to extend a line. The command is ex, so you just type ex, so it will come. So go to the software. Now see, for example, we have a line like this, and there is one more line in this direction. Now this line I want to extend from this point to this line. So I can, what can I do if I want to join this line to this line? So what we can do as we have learned till now, so simply we can take one more line, enter, and just join here, shift right click, perpendicular option, so just join here. But if you do like that, then this element will be different, this element will be different, both elements are different. So if you want to make them a single element, well, there is one more command, which pedit, that I will explain. But you can use the extend command. So I will delete that. You can use this extend command just to extend the same line up to this boundary, right? So let's see how this works. So we are in extend command. In the command bar, type ex, press enter. Now please follow the steps that I am doing here. Type the extend command ex, enter, then select the boundary first. Select the boundary first. So it is asking to select objects, so select the boundary first. Now this is the boundary. Again press enter, then select objects to extend. So already you can see it is happening. Just click there. Now you can see this whole thing is one element, so we can use this. So this will be more helpful in geometries like one I will demonstrate. So let me turn this off. Say we have circle here and we have a line, say from the quadrant, it's not coming, L enter, quadrant, from here we have a line like this. Now offset, use the offset command, say 6 enter, don't use this 6, it's very small. Delete this line. I'm just demonstrating how this extend command will be helpful for us. So I'm just trying to create some geometry. So okay, so offset enter, say 20 enter. It's still very small. Okay, delete, offset enter. Okay, this should work now. 60 enter. Yes. Now see, we have offset this line, but you can see if we zoom this part, then you can see now this line is touching the circle, but these lines are not touching the circle. So it may appear, although it appears as if it these lines, the offset lines, are touching the boundary of this circle, but if you zoom, actually they are not touching. So this is some mistake is there, so we need to rectify it. So how to rectify it? So rather than creating line and joining here, we can extend this line from here to here. So this is how we can make use of the extend command. So ex, enter, select the boundary, again enter, then select this line like this. So we have done it. So it's very easy. So this is how we can make use of the extend command. So this is about the extend command. Let's go to the next command, that is hatch. Now this is used to represent a cut section. So just type in this HA in the command bar, and from that we can use this hatch. So let's go to the drawing. Now in order to give hatch command or to use this, we should have some drawing. Say I have a rectangle and I want to do hatching for this rectangle. Hatching means some creating some lines at some spacing and at an angle of 45 degree, which is a standard. So let's do hatching for this. So use the command HA, press enter, then select the region which we want to hatch. So just move the mouse cursor over the region and click there. After this, press the escape key. So like this we have created the hatch. Now so since we have created this hatch, we need to do some changes here. That means the hatch is not properly visible. So if I can zoom it, you can see the lines are visible at some spacing, but only when I zoom this. So it should be visible at some in this window. So change the scale type, select the hatch, and here we can give some value, say 100, and check whether it is coming or not. So it is coming a little bit. Again select, then give some value, say some larger value, 600, enter. Now you can see, press the escape key, so it's coming. So we can further increase it just to get the right spacing. Yes, now this is properly visible. So this is how we can use the hatch option. So it's very simple, just type in the HA, press enter, then select the region. Now the region can be a rectangle, or it may be a region bounded by lines and arcs, so whatever. So we can do this hatching using this command. So you can also find the hatch tool somewhere here in the toolbar, so you need to search for it and you can directly use it. Now this is on the hatch command. So let's go to the Word file and see the next type. It's pEdit. Now this is used to convert the line segment into a single polyline. So we need to understand first what does it mean by a line segment and what is a single polyline. And to convert this line segments into a polyline, we have to use this command, pEdit. So just type in this command and let's do the operation. So go to the software. First, let me delete this one. Now suppose I have a line like this. That means I have a set of lines here. Now this whole thing is my object. So if I want to select the whole object, I have to select these individual elements one by one. So which may be time consuming or may be a problematic. So if I want to select this whole object, so it should be like, if I select one line, then the whole object should get selected. Now to do it, that means these are line segments. These are line segments. So I want to convert this line segments into one single polyline. One single polyline means, if I select this, whole line should get selected. Either this or this. If I select, then the whole object should get selected. So that is the polyline. So, okay, let's use the command. Type here pEdit, press enter. Now select polyline. That means select one of the line segment. Either you can select this, this or this. So let me select this one. So once we have selected this first, you can say the element, then you read what command bar is asking. Do you want to turn it into one? So by default it is Y, that means S. So just press enter key. Now again read. Or you can see here the options are available, close, join, width and other. And also this drop down menu will appear once you press enter. So just select this one, join, and now you can read here select objects. So simply go on selecting those objects. So don't select this one, we have already done it, no need to select it again. Select this one, select this, and select this. Once this is done, press the enter key, and after that press escape key. Now you just move your mouse on this object, you can see the whole line is getting selected. That means the whole object is getting selected. So this is how we converted single line elements, line segments, into a whole polyline. So this is on the pEdit command. I just want to repeat this pEdit command just to show you again. So pEdit, enter the first object, enter, select join, then select the remaining objects, enter and escape. Now you can see. Once we select, then we can move this element anywhere, the whole element. So this was on pedit command. So in this tutorial, so we have learned all these modification commands. So thank you very much for watching.